you action figure enthusiasts out there. JC here with another TNI toy review. And today's review is in association with MarvelousNews.com, your number one news source for everything Marvel. And for today's review, we're going to be taking a look at the newest Marvel Legends Deluxe Rider set from Hasbro with the Ultimate Captain America and World War II motorcycle. Now, this set comes packaged in a window box, so you've got clearly displayed both the figure and the vehicle. You've got down below the Captain America logo. Also shown is the Marvel Comics 80th anniversary logo. On the sides of the packaging, you've got some pretty cool artwork. And then on the back of the packaging, you've got a look at the actual toy, along with all the features and accessories that come with it, a brief bio in multiple languages, and then down below, other Rider sets, the Deadpool and the Professor Xavier and hover chair. All right, let's get this open and take a look at what's inside. Okay, so here's a look at the set outside of the packaging along with the other contents. You know, we'll start off taking a look at the motorcycle, and this is based on a World War II motorcycle, and there is some minor assembly required like we've seen with the previous deluxe vehicles that Hasbro's released in the line. So first thing you'll want to do is take the handlebars. Now before I attach the bars to the bike, I just wanted to give you an up-close look, and you've got some nice detailing. You've got a little decal there for the speedometer there in the middle. Same with the mirror, it's just a sticker, so there's no reflectiveness or anything. You've got some sculpting detail on the black handle grips, which looks good, and then you've got the brakes on both sides. They don't work or anything, but they, you know, did include those. And then the rest of the bars are just done with an army type green plastic. And attaching the handlebars to the bike is pretty simple. You've got a little hole here on the bike, and then you've got the little peg pieces on the bottom of the handlebars, and all you do is you take those and you just plug them into that hole and it should click into place. The next thing you'll probably want to do is take the saddlebags and attach them to the back of the bike. So I like the detailing on these saddlebags. They're actually workable. You can pull open the flaps and you can stick stuff in there if you wanted to, and you get two. So you get the one that has this piece that goes over the top of the back of the bike, and you got a little peg there. And then what you want to do is take this other saddlebag, and again, this one you can open up, but what you want to do is you just take these holes, and you got these little pegs here, and you just plug them in. And then what you want to do is you want to take this little peg on the underside and plug it into this hole on the top of the bike. And then there's a hole on this saddlebag that you want to plug into this piece here that sticks out. So you just kind of put it over there and slide it in, and that's pretty much it. And so you have the saddlebags on both sides. And again, you can actually put stuff in there, which is cool. You can have the flaps kind of open, or you can close them, and they will stay closed pretty good. And you know, the saddlebags do stay attached to the bike good, so you don't have to worry about them falling off. Next up, you get this holster for the rifle that's included for the figure. And the rifle is removable from the holster, and it looks like a World War II type rifle. It is just done in black, so there's really no paint detail on the weapon. But overall, it looks pretty good. And then, like I said, it fits into this holster, and it does fit in there nice and tight. And then what you want to do is this attaches to the bike on the right side up here by the front wheel. There are these two little tabs, and what you want to do is just, you've got the holes on the holster, and you just plug that in. And then for the left side of the bike, they've included this little ammo case. Now this does not open, it's just a solid piece of plastic. It feels hollow, but there, you can't open the top or anything, so you can't put bullets or anything in there. But what you want to do with this one is, again, you've got the two holes on the back side, and you've got the little pegs here on the front wheel, and you just take it and you match up the holes with the pegs, and it attaches to the front there. Okay, so here's a look at the bike with all the attachments on it, and I think Hasbro's done a pretty good job. So this is supposed to look like a World War II motorcycle, and for the most part it does. I mean, I'm not an expert on World War II vehicles, but that's what it looks like to me. You've got basic paint applications for the most part. You've just got this army green throughout most of the bike. You've got some black here on the engine with some silver wash. And then like up here on the front fender, you've got some metallic silver scratch marks for a little added detail. But overall, the bike looks very clean. There's really no dirt or anything like that. You know, maybe if they added some more scratch marks or dirt or something, so it looked like it was actually out, you know, on the battlefield, it would be better. But still, you know, I don't think it looks bad. You've got some sculpting detail on the engine parts and stuff. And, you know, you've got the little brake lights, even though when you have the bags attached, you can't really see those. You've got the exhaust pipes. And some of this, these parts look like are reused from the Ghost Rider motorcycle. So, you know, these exhaust pipes look like the same ones that were on the Ghost Rider bike. But still, to me, you've done a good job of capturing the look of a World War II bike, and especially with all the other attachments on it. Now, you've got that working kickstand like we've seen with the other motorcycles they've done. So you can either have it so you've got the two stands so that keeps the bike from falling over. You can flip it completely up so there's no kickstand. And if you have a figure on there, you know, it won't fall over. But if you don't, it will kind of fall over. It does roll well. The wheels are done with a hard rubber, but you know, it rolls pretty good here, you can see. And then you can also put the kickstand down so that you've just got the actual kickstand portion. So it, you know, again, with that, it's probably gonna fall over unless you have a figure on it. But for looks, if you want just kind of the actual kickstand, you can do that. But for display purposes, it's better to have the two pegs so it's standing like that. Other details they've included, you've got the white star on the front there on both sides. And then you have the brown seat that has some texturing so it looks like actual leather. And you also have the gas cap. I think this piece might be from the Ghost Rider bike. This front piece might be from the Ghost Rider bike as well, but you do have that gas cap there. Okay, now for the figure itself, for actual accessories that come with the figure, you have a pistol that's in this gun holster. It's actually in the holster when you take it out of the packaging, but the pistol itself is removable. And like with the rifle that you can attach to the bike, this is done with just a black plastic. So you don't have a lot of paint detail, but it does look like an actual pistol, and you have some sculpting detail with the ridges on the handle and everything. So that looks pretty good. You also get a knife, and this is, you know, we've seen this accessory before with other Marvel Legend figures. You've got the black handle, and you've got a working sheath here on his left boot. So you can slide that in there. Store that, so that's cool. And then the final accessory is this classic shield, the triangle shield with the stars and stripes on it, and this looks pretty good. I have a little mark on the white portion there, but otherwise looks good. On the back side, it's just a solid red color. And then like with all the Captain America shields, you have either the peg so you can plug it into the back, or you can flip it up so you got the clip so you can put it on his wrist. The one last accessory I should note is the helmet, which is removable. So, you know, this is based on the ultimate version of Captain America from his World War II days, which is very different looking than in the original comics. In the original comics, he wore an outfit that was very comic book-like, you know, spandex type-like. But in the Ultimate Universe, his outfit, just like in the movies, is much more military accurate. You still got the red, white, and blue colors of Captain America. You still got the star on his chest, which is actually sculpted on the figure, and you've got the red and the white at the midsection. But like the helmet is an actual army helmet, and again, this is removable, so you can take that off. You still have the under mask, the brown mask with the goggles on there. That's not removable, but you can take the helmet off. You've got the little strap there, which is done with a rubber material. You can't, I don't think, no, you can't attach the strap, so the strap just has to hang there. But you know, I'm glad that they allowed you to be able to take that off. You've got the A painted on the helmet, and the blue of the helmet matches up with the rest of the outfit nicely. He's also wearing this harness piece, you know, something you would see a military officer wear with the pouches and everything, and the working gun holster, which does snap closed and holds that pistol nice and tight. You got the pouches and everything. This is a separate piece. And then he's just got like the thicker looking shirt and the army looking pants with the pouches sculpted on the side. The gloves and the boots are a brown color as opposed to red. And then you've also got the black on the boots. And you even have some nice detailing on the soles there. The harness piece is removable. It just clips on over here on the side, so if you want to take it off, you can. So I think the figure looks better with the harness on rather than off. Now this figure stands with his helmet on right about 6 3/4 inches tall. And here's a comparison of the modern regular Captain America figure, the Cap Wolf figure, and you can see these two are about the same height. Now, I've never really been into the Ultimates that much, to be quite honest with you, and the only Marvel Legend Ultimate figure I've owned besides this Cap is the original Iron Man figure that Hasbro did when they first took over the license. And you can see here that the Captain America figure is definitely taller than Iron Man, so these two figures really aren't in scale with one another. Here's the Ultimate Captain America figure the Diamond Select Toys did for their Marvel Select line. This thing was basically a statue with very little articulation. This was one of the older Marvel Select figures, but just wanted to give you a comparison of the two. And here's a comparison of the MCU Marvel Legend First Avenger Captain America figure that Hasbro did. And I believe, you know, they loosely based this MCU outfit on the Ultimate World War II version of Cap. And then finally, here's a comparison with the MCU World War II versions of Red Skull and the Hydra Soldier. Now for articulation on this figure, let me take the helmet off. You can turn the head to the left and to the right. It's on a ball hinge joint. So he can look down about that much, and then he can look back pretty good as well. You get some head pivot with this one, so overall pretty good head movement. Now with the arm, you can get his arm out about that much. You do not have any kind of butterfly joint or anything. He can rotate the arm there at the shoulder good. You get a bicep swivel. You get a double hinged elbow, so pretty good bending there at the elbow. You get the rotation with the hands, and then you have the hinges with the hands, so you've got the up and down movement. He's got a midsection joint where you can rotate, though you've got this harness piece, so that does limit some of that movement, and he really doesn't have any crunch forward movement, and he does have some back movement, a little back movement there, but as far as crunching forward, that's about as much as you can get. And then you have a waist swivel with this one as well. With the legs, he can do the splits that much. You can get the leg up high pretty good, and you can do the leg out and back. You've got the thigh swivel. You've got a double jointed knee, so good bending there at the knee. You've got a boot cuff swivel. Now with this one with the knife, it does limit some of that movement, but you do get a boot cuff swivel. And then with the feet, you have the hinges, so up and down movement, and you do have ankle pivot and two peg holes on the bottom of the feet. Okay, and here's a look at the figure on the actual bike, and you can see it fits on there pretty good. Holds the handlebars, you can get the feet down to the pedals, so fits nicely on the bike. A little detail I did notice, you've got the little US on the gun holster there. Let me zoom in on that so you can see that. So that's a nice little added detail. And one thing I want to note about the shield, so the shield does not attach to the bike in any way. If you want to have the shield with Cap on the bike, you've got to put it on its back like we see with normal shields and Captain America figures. You just plug it in there. But unfortunately, you can't like put it on the front here. I don't know if that's something the Ultimate Cap ever did with his World War II bike or not. When I think of Captain American motorcycles, I always think about him putting it on the front there. But as it is, you know, you can only attach it to the back of the figure if you want him to have his shield while he's on the motorcycle. And on the front here, you've just got, you know, you can see the little headlight, and you've got this little circle piece here. This looks like it's made to look like leather or something, and you got the little stitching, and then you've got the clear plastic windshield. Okay, so that's my review. So when this set was first announced, you know, I'm a huge Captain America fan, but as I said, I'm really never been into the Ultimate storyline, so I was a little hesitant on whether I wanted to get this set or not. But having gotten it, I have to say I'm pretty impressed with it. The overall figure is nice, the motorcycle is pretty cool, and you get some pretty cool accessories for both the bike and the figure. So even if you're not into Ultimates like me, you still may want to check this one out. And definitely if you are into the Ultimate storylines, I think this is one you'll definitely want to add to your collection. Now this set is available now. We'll have a full image gallery up at MarvelousNews.com. There'll be a link in the video description below. As always, leave a comment, let me know what you think. If you're so inclined, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell notification so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. And of course, you can follow me on my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. I have links to those in the video description as well. Until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.